Hi, in this video, I'm going to give you a quick overview of Agile CRM. Agile CRM is where you can manage all of your leads, clients, and prospects, track your sales pipelines and deals, provide top-notch support to your customers through our ticket support system, and create any kind of form you want. In this video, we are going to highlight how our CRM can help your business. So let's dive in. Let's start with contacts. Contacts are individuals with whom your company has a relationship or potential relationship. So let's go to contacts. As you can see, I have many contacts in my CRM. This is where I can see all of the contacts and their details in this table. And if I want to see a specific contact, I can click on the contact name to see all the details related to them. So now let's create a new contact. In Agile, contacts can be of three types: a lead, a prospect, or a client. A lead is someone who has shown any kind of interest in your products or services. A prospect is a qualified lead who is likely to become your customer. Client is someone who has already purchased your products or services and has an established relationship with your company. So now let's create a client. I'm going to add a first name. I can add all kind of details like their address, city, etc. Assign it to a sales agent. If I have teammates, I can assign this contact to a sales agent so they can add information or notes for them. And I can add the life cycle stage where they are at, etc., their tax number, yearly income. And I can, if I want to categorize them into tags or lists, I can do that from here. Let's say this came from the website, so I can add website tag to this, and I can add their profile picture, etc. And then we have this option, send invite to client right away. What this will do is that it will send a client portal invite to your client where they will be able to see all of their information, invoices, projects, etc. in their client portal. So let's save this contact. So you saw how easy it was to create the contact like client, lead, or prospect in Agile. If you want to import your contacts, you can click on this import option and upload the CSV file, map fields, and import all of your previous contacts in Agile. We also have integrations with leading platforms that can help you import all of your contacts data in Agile. Let me show you what kind of information you can save for contacts. So I'm in the contact details screen, and we have this action column where you can quickly convert this to a prospect, invite them, or impersonate their client portal. When you impersonate their client portal, you will be able to see how their client portal looks. You can see all the information related to the contact. We have notes here. You can add notes for this contact. Let's say if you want to save some information for your teammates to see, you can add notes. Then we have deals where you can create deals for them. Then we have emails. If you want to log emails that you have already sent them, or if you want to send emails from Agile, you can do that. To send an email, just click on send email button and select the connected email account and write an email and send. We also have Agile AI that can help you professional and fantastic emails. So this was send email option. Then we have tasks. If you want to add tasks for this client, you can add them here. So you can assign these tasks to your client or your teammates. You can add, let's say, upload. Upload logo, and I can assign it to the client and save this. So they'll be able to see this task in their client portal. And then we have files. If you want to upload files for this client, you can click on this add file button and upload the files here. Then we have meetings where you can add personal meeting, or you can add event or meeting for them or appointment for them. Then we have projects where you will be able to see all the projects that you are working with this client here in Agiled. You can quickly add a project from here as well. Then we have invoices where you will be able to see all the invoices for this contact. And then we have proposals, contracts, estimates, and activities. So you can see all the information related to this contact in the contact information. If you have added custom fields for this contact, you will be able to see them here. And if you want to update information for this client, you can quickly update this information and it will be saved automatically. So this was contacts. Now let's move on to accounts. In CRM, accounts are companies or entities to which services are provided. In Agile CRM, you can save all the information about the entities, companies, or organizations that you are working with. As you can see, I've saved these many companies in my CRM accounts. So if I go to any of these, I'll be able to see all the information and contacts related to them. So I can see their address, etc. I can see the notes that I have or my teammates have added for them. I can see all the deals that we are working on with them and all the emails that we have sent them, all the tasks that have been created for them or for my teammates. We have all the files related to these accounts. We have meetings and activity log. So we have quick options like edit or delete, and from here we can see the contacts that are related to them. And as you can see, we have added some contacts here. To add an account, all you have to do is click on add account button. Add account name, let's say add account description, etc. You can add address. You can assign it to sales agent. You can add text number, etc. Their company size, their social media accounts, notes, etc. And then save it. This is how easy it is to save the accounts. And if you want to import the accounts from your previous CRM or previous system or your CSV file, you can do that by clicking import button and following the instructions and mapping the fields and clicking on the submit button. So it is really easy. So this was CRM accounts, where you can save all the information related to the companies or entities that you are working with. Now let's move on to deals. Deals are sales opportunities or potential sales that are tracked through different stages of a sales process or a sales pipeline. So I'm on the CRM pipeline deals page, and as you can see, I've created a sales pipeline or a sales process where the first part is prospecting part, then it is proposal sending part, then we have contract, then we have closed, and this is a custom stage. So I can create a deal and track this deal through different stages of a sales pipeline. As you can see, I have this deal in the prospecting part. I can take this, and when I have sent the proposal to them or my teammate has sent the proposal to them, they can move this to the proposal send part. So this is how easy it is to track the deals in sales in Agiled. If you want to view the deals, you can click on the view button and it will take you to a deals details screen, and you can see their progress, the deal progress in the deal details as well. So we have deal details where you can see which pipeline this deal is in, which sales agent this is assigned to, and the type, etc., and all other details. You can add notes for these deals as well, and you can send email for this deal to the contact or the lead or the client who you are working with. Then you can add tasks for your teammates for this deal. And then we have files. If you have any files related to this deal, you can add them here to organize all the things related to this deal in one place. Then we have meetings, and then we have activity log where you can see all the activity related to this deal from the moment it was created here. So you can see different actions for this deal here. And let me go back to the deal screen and let me show you different options to visualize these deals. So we have the Kanban wheel or the sales pipeline view of this sales pipeline. And then we have table view where you can see all the details in our table. So this was deals. Now let's move on to tickets. Tickets is where you can provide top-notch support to your customers in Agile. Customers can create tickets from their client portal, or you can create a form where they can submit their queries and tickets will be automatically created in Agile. We have a separate video on that and you can watch that to set that up. And so this is the ticket screen where you can see all the tickets that have been requested by your clients. You can also create a ticket yourself by clicking this create ticket button. You can add all the information related to the ticket. Let's say the website is down, add the description, add the request name, choose the agent, the project type, etc. And then add files if there are any files related to this ticket, and click on submit button to create this ticket. Once the ticket has been created, you can click on this reply option to reply to this ticket, and the reply will be sent to your client and they'll be able to see in the client portal, or they'll receive an email with the reply. We have all these options for tickets where you can add reply templates to quickly reply to your team to your tickets. You can add ticket types, ticket channels, etc. So we have these ticket types, questions, problem, incident, and we have reply templates as well where you can add a reply template. Let's say default reply. So you'll be able to use these reply templates to quickly answer the tickets in Agile. So this was the tickets. Now let's move on to forms. Forms is where you can create any kind of form you want for your business or for your clients, etc. You can create lead forms to collect leads and add that data in Agile. Or you can create questionnaires to get responses from your clients. Or you can create a survey or any kind of form. You can embed these forms on your website or share these forms directly with your visitors or clients. Creating a form in Agile is really easy. We have an intuitive drag and drop form builder that you can use to create and customize any kind of form you want. So to create a new form, all you have to do is click on this create new button. Add the form name, let's say then choose the action on submission. If you are creating a journal entry form, then you can choose general entry. If you want to create a lead with this form, you can choose create lead. If you want to create clients on the submission from this form, you can choose create client. And if you want to choose create ticket, then you can choose create ticket. Also, when you choose create lead, it automatically gives you an option to assign the lead to a sales agent to automate. If you are creating a lead, then it will also give you an option to create a project automatically for that client and assign a workflow to it. We have a separate video on that. You can watch that in our help section or on our YouTube channel. And if you are creating a ticket, then you have a sales agent that you can assign the ticket. Let's move on with the general entries form and action after successful submission. We have a show message that you can use to show any kind of message that the form has been submitted, or you can redirect the user to a different URL, to a custom URL. And if you want to set an expiry date for the form, you can do that from here. I will remove expiry and click proceed to builder. So this is the drag and drop form builder that comes with many widgets. We have a separate video or detailed video on forms as well. In this video, I'm just giving you a quick overview. So we have all these widgets like text, heading, input fields, number, text area, etc. that you can use to create your forms. And we have these layouts as well, where you can create a single column, multiple columns, three columns, etc. You can create nested layouts as well. So I'm going to delete this and I can add heading. Let's say forms. You can choose the font size, etc. for this. You can choose the font type, and we have all these other options for the text here. Also, Agile forms come with templates, so you can create any kind of form template you want and reuse that template whenever you are creating a new form. Or you can use form templates provided by Agile to create a new lead form, questionnaire, etc. If you want to choose a template, you can click on change template and click on any of the template that you want to apply. So let's say I want to create a contact us form. So I will click on this and click on apply button. So it will apply the template to this form. As you can see, it has been applied. And now I can preview it in the mobile or desktop view. And if I want to change the color, etc. of the background, I can do that from here. So you can customize the form in any way you want. And once I'm done with the form, I can click on the save button and click on share button to share this form. As you can see, we have two options here. You can share the form link, or you can share or you can embed the form in your website or landing page or a sales page. Let me show you how this form looks in another tab. So as you can see, this is the public view of the form, and you can customize everything about this form from the builder. Now let's go back and see how you can see submissions for the forms. So these are all the forms that I have created, and if I want to see submissions for the form, I can click on these three dots and click on submissions button. So these are all the submissions, and I can also export these submissions if I want. If I want to clone a form, I can clone it, I can view the public form, I can edit or delete the form. So this was forms, and this was a quick overview of our CRM. If you need any help with the CRM, you can always reach out to us at support@agile.app. We have all these detailed videos on all the features and options in CRM on our YouTube channel and in our help section. You can always refer to those videos if you need any kind of help. So we hope this video was very helpful for you, and we believe that Agile CRM can help your business grow and organize your contacts, leads, clients, deals efficiently. So thank you so much for watching the video.